Epilepsy can range from people who you would never know they had seizures to people just drop.
There are all kinds of seizures. There are partial simple seizures, partial complex seizures.
Depends on what parts of the brain the seizures are coming from. It could present just in many different ways. From personal problems with epilepsy to, you know, continuing to take medication, it is quite disruptive to one's life.
I will see the patients when during the neurosurgical workup where they've tried 3 or 4 medicines or even 5 or 6 and it still hasn't stopped the seizures. So then they'll go to a neurosurgery workup to identify, can we find out where it's coming from? Can the surgery fix a problem, or what else needs to be done?
Now, of those patients, only about 20% of those are candidates for resective surgery to remove this area that causes the seizures without causing any damage to the rest of the brain.
Sometimes there are seizures that come from locations where you can't take part of the brain out, or they come in from multiple locations. And that's where things like DBS are pretty exciting.
So for those patients, neuromodulation is critical. Deep brain stimulation modulates the circuitry that can help control the seizures while sparing the critical areas of the brain.
The DBS can quiet it down or stop the seizures from happening in many cases. So it allows uncontrollable seizures to be controlled without taking parts of the brain out.
Deep brain stimulation involves placement of electrodes in a central hub of the brain. It's called the thalamus, in a nucleus in the thalamus. And what it does is that it continuously stimulates to modulate the circuitry that a lot of these seizure networks utilize in spread. So we continuously take images to make sure that the electrodes are exactly where we want them in the thalamus. The Yale Epilepsy Program has a half a century history of a very collaborative program, and this is also backed by intense scientific, basic, and clinical research to actually push the field. So Yale, you know, sits at a wonderful place.
We really see a lot of complicated cases. It's a prime place to go to find out how to stop a person's seizures in the least invasive manner.
So this is an exciting time in epilepsy. Almost everyone who has medication refractory epilepsy has a treatment option. We're learning more and more about seizure networks, how they occur, and developing more targeted therapies to treat epilepsy.